session being done and presided.
Everybody bow with me for the invocation, please. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us together again and continue to look after one of our members here that's battling some health issues, and pray that we will do your will in everything we do as a county commission. In your holy name I pray, amen.
Amen.
Billy Phillips, would you lead us in the pledge, please?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, number four, clerk, we call the roll, please.
Billy Phillips.
Yeah, here.
Jesse Bowman.
Here.
Darwin Clark.
Here.
Gil McCowen.
Here.
Shane Walker.
Here.
Frank Martin.
Here.
Robbie Melton. Jeff Long.
Here.
Gene Moore. Greg Givens.
Here.
Geraldine Walker.
Here.
Meta Boswell. Lee Richards.
Here.
Philip Tally.
Here.
Donna Savage.
All right, we got 11 present, we got four. Number five, approve the minutes for April 12th, 2021 county commission meeting. Motion by Billy Phillips, second by Geraldine Walker. Is there any discussion on that? All four say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Number six, consider approval for resolution 2021-0510-01. That's a resolution authorizing the expenditure of excess proceeds from the capital outlay note series 2018 to be used for the purchase of highway equipment and or renovation of the ambulance service. And that's been approved by the budget committee. And I think that's kind of around $300,000. We looked at buying some equipment for the highway department to help them be able to pick up the brush debris we've got from the ice storm with that, because we will probably be able to use the federal funds we're getting to add on to the ambulance service. Motion by Darwin Clark, second by Jesse Bowman. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Billy Phillips.
Yes.
Jesse Bowman.
Yes.
Darwin Clark.
Yes.
Gil McCowen.
Yes.
Shane Walker.
Yes.
Frank Martin.
Yes.
Jeff Long.
Yes.
Greg Givens.
Yes.
Geraldine Walker.
Yes.
Lee Richards.
Yes.
Philip Tally.
Yes.
Donna Savage.
All right, motion passes. Number seven, consider approval of county quarterly reports ending March 31st, 2021. And that's been approved by the budget committee. Motion by Philip Tally, second by Darwin Clark. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Philip Tally.
Yes.
Lee Richards.
Yes.
Geraldine Walker.
Yes.
Greg Givens.
Yes.
Gene Moore. Jeff Long.
Yes.
Frank Martin.
Yes.
Shane Walker.
Yes.
Gil McCowen.
Yes.
Darwin Clark.
Yes.
Jesse Bowman.
Yes.
Billy Phillips.
Yes.
Motion passes. Number eight, consider approval of the following budget amendments. General Fund 101, amendment number six, and General Capital Projects 171, amendment number two. That's been approved by the budget committee, and the only thing that needs to be changed on page eight on your list, you've got where it's got a third of the way down where it shows the fund number 101-53330-419. That needs to be 719. That is explosives, 419 is, so I don't think the drug court officers buying explosives, so we got a typo on that one, so that's on the change that needs to be made in that. Motion by Darwin Clark, second by Frank Martin. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Billy Phillips.
Yes.
Jesse Bowman.
Yes.
Darwin Clark.
Yes.
Gil McCowen.
Yes.
Shane Walker.
Yes.
Frank Martin.
Yes.
Jeff Long.
Yes.
Greg Givens.
Yes.
Geraldine Walker.
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Robbie just got here.
Robbie Melton?
We're voting on the budget amendments on number eight.
Yes.
approval for petition to deem a portion of Virgil Murphy Circle a private road. And that was unanimously not approved by the Highway and County Property Committee based on road superintendent's recommendation to keep this a county road. Your agenda says a public road, but it's a county road, so that needs to say county road instead of public road. Andrea Ayers is here, and she's the ones that petitions attorney, and I told them they can have 10 minutes to speak to the court, and they came to the Highway Committee and voted not to close the road, but I told you to come and speak, so Andrea, if you want to come and speak to the commission on.
Will there be other people speaking on the issue?
Well, I was gonna give you all 10 minutes, and then some of the public wants to speak, I'll let them.
Okay, I would just request that I be allowed to speak at the end, since I've got 10 minutes.
You get 10 minutes total, so however you want to.
I get 10 minutes?
Yeah, then they'll get 10 minutes, and then we're gonna vote on it.
That's fine, I would like to speak at the end, if that's okay.
Well, that's fine. Do we have anybody from Waterloo, Hardy Chapel area that'd like to, and I'm gonna give up to 10 minutes to everybody, you know, that's here, if you want to, I mean, all together.
I'm against it being closed, it needs to remain a county road, it's always been a county road, so.
I'm also against it being closed. It's always been public road.
I'm against it being closed.
Yes, it's always been a public county road, has been ever since I was a kid. We have no other way to get to the creek anymore since they built a new bridge down there, and there's no way to even get there at the end of the bridge, like you used to be able to go down and enjoy the falls. Can't do that anymore, if they close that road off, there's no access going down to Waterloo and the creek, so.
It's more than just a river to us. Our families have been baptized there, our children have went there to fish. I went there myself and fished. My grandparents used to take me there, my grandpa did, when I was 5, 6 year old on the. It's not just a river, it's our community.
I would like to object to it as well. My family's lived there for 75 years. And I've moved back in 2011 after retiring. And my parents have both deceased. And closing the road, they put up gates, and now people are coming past my house and turning around there because they can't get through. And they're coming to my door knocking, wanting to know what's going on. And so it's just not working, that it's locked off with gates. And I think it needs to be a county road. It needs to be maintained by the county because right now it's in really bad shape, especially in front of my house.
When they first came down there, they told us that local people would be allowed to continue to go down into the river there and do picnics, fishing, what have you. But it's since changed what I've heard. I haven't tried to go down there myself. I've talked to some people that have tried to go. They did allow one or two to go that I've heard. I don't know for a fact. I haven't talked to those people. But I have recently been told that they don't want any of us down in there. That it needs to be considered as private property.
Well, what they're doing is charging down there. So they have on a website, on their website, $6 a day. So I understand that they're bought the land, they're trying to make profit out of it. But Waterloo's always been open. My family was there, so.
I think it needs to be opened completely back up where you can make the circle and come back out. There used to be a water line down there when Tommy Murphy, he maintained it and everything. We'd go down there, come off the creek, it was heavily fed, he'd go down there and wash your car and everything, you know. Just something we're losing, it's a landmark kind of, you know.
Anybody else want to? Okay, Andrea, you want to?
May I come forward?
Yeah, that's fine, you come up here.
Thank you.
tonight in your meeting to address this issue. I think the people who have came from the community as well, and I believe that Davies know and understand how important Waterloo is and has been to people in the community and what special memories it holds for them. I think someone just referenced the fact that they were losing a landmark. If you've been down there, you have seen for yourself what they've done to the property. It looks wonderful. They've made so many improvements to the property. In fact, quite the opposite. You're not losing a landmark. They're preserving it for the community. We submitted this petition to the Highway Committee on March 26th. It was considered at the April 8th Highway Committee meeting, as Mr. Danner referenced. The petition was discussed at great length, and I appreciate the committee's patience and time in discussing at that time, but it was ultimately recommended for denial, and now it's before the full commission for your consideration. As I've indicated in the documents submitted, this request to close a portion of this road is simply a 300-foot portion of Virgil Murphy. It is not the entire road. It is simply the portion of Virgil Murphy that extends into the Davies property. At the Highway Committee meeting, the concern was brought up that there may be a small little strip of land owned by Mr. Eldon Leslie that might potentially be affected by this request as well. We still don't have full clarity on that matter just yet. However, Ms. Pam Gentry, who is the eldest daughter of Eldon Leslie and also his power of attorney, was at that committee meeting on April 8th. She is in full support of the Davies petition on behalf of her father, and she also joined in signing that petition on behalf of her father at that committee meeting. Her signature is not on the copies that you all have, that you all were provided, but it was on the county executive's copy at the meeting that night. I don't have a copy of that to provide tonight, but that meeting was recorded and everyone saw that Ms. Gentry did sign on as an adjoining landowner, and she also voiced her support for the Davies request. So what you have before you tonight and what is required by law is an agreement of the adjoining landowners that are affected by the request. Again, it's only the 300 feet of the road that goes into the Davies property. It's completely surrounded by the Davies property. Traveling this portion of the road leads to nowhere but the Davies property. We have heard several people here tonight voice opposition to this request, to their petition. In all due respect, I appreciate their concern and their input, but it's simply their opinion. I believe Miss Elizabeth and a landowner on the upper side of the road, she voiced her opposition at the committee meeting on April 8th. In all due respect, that's her opinion, and that's fine, but she does not have standing to contest this. It is only the only people that have standing to contest this are the adjoining landowners. So you have landowners who are in agreement to close the road. I think Mr. Danner pointed out that this was an issue of a county road and not a public road, so I do not need to address that. The 300-foot portion of the road is basically the driveway that leads to their business. It stays in constant disrepair because it's in a floodplain and it requires constant maintenance. I think Elizabeth even stated how terrible the road condition is right now. This much needed maintenance has not been performed by the county on this particular section of the road for years. Last year when I was down there at one point, there was a mud hole, which was considered the road, that was the length of almost this room here. and people were constantly getting stuck in there. It's just not been maintained by the family. This piece of property has never been public property. It has always been private property. The former owners just simply weren't around to monitor people coming in and out. I think they may have lived in Texas. Even the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation acknowledges on their website that there is no public access to the waterfalls. There is no access to the waterfalls. The only way, if I can give everyone copies of this off of their website, says no public access points. Bears can hike a 1/2 mile on a creek trail into the gorge from a pull-off on Highway 136 to view the waterfall. That's on the Department of Environment and Conservation's website. So I brought copies of that for everyone on the commission. It's for you to see. So even the Department of Environment and Conservation acknowledges that there is no public access. And I understand the community's concern in saying, well, we've always been able to go down there. And I understand that. And the Davies are not completely cutting it off to the public. But it's their private property that they have paid for, and they have a business down there. They have to be able to monitor it. They have to be able to monitor who's coming in and out. The liability risks are just inherently dangerous to allow trespassers just to come in. What if someone got hurt down there? So when people come in, they have to know who's there, they have to sign in, and they have to be able to monitor who's there. Petition would not change anything about how the public accesses the property. It's still private property, regardless of whether you all grant this petition today or deny it. It is still private property. If you grant this request, the Davies will reroute the existing 300 feet of road out of the floodplain that it's currently in. I think you all can see the conservation report that was attached to the petition. The Davies are trying to work with a conservation group to properly restore the riverbanks there. If you grant that, they will do away with the road as it in its existing state, just the portion that's in their property. We're not talking about anything past their property line. We're only talking about the road that comes through their property. It dead ends to their property. This would make the property more attractive and accessible for their guests. They will bear the burden of the expense of this regrouting of the road. Even though the county isn't currently maintaining this portion of the road, the county would save money in theory if they actually did maintain it, because the Davies would be taking care of it instead. If you do not grant this request, the road will continue to flood, blocking access to anyone who would want to come to Waterloo. The county road just simply ends in the middle of the Davy property. The road does not extend to the creek at all. There's no easement that goes down to the river. The county road, as it is, dead ends to their property. The road's current state only encourages trespass at this point because they can't monitor it. When you all discuss this issue and before you vote, I submit to you that this is the question that you need to ask. What legitimate county purpose is served by denying this request? What purpose does it serve for the county to deny this request that is a legitimate county purpose? What legitimate county purpose is served by keeping this 300-foot section of road that is a dead end into the Davies property and stays in constant disrepair? You have the affected landowners in agreement. What purpose does it serve? The only argument, if you were at the highway committee meeting, The only argument, in all due respect to Mr. Nord, was that, well, people have always accessed the falls and the creek via the Davies property. It's always been that way. Unfortunately, that is not a valid or legitimate argument when looking at this issue. Legally, all of those people were trespassers over the years, but nobody was there to enforce it or do anything. That's kind of the same, you know, same thing as saying, well, my friend lived in this house over here for 30 years, and I went there all the time, and I played as a kid in their backyard. Well, now that house is owned by somebody else. I think I should still be able to go over there and play in that backyard. It's just not a valid position to take when we're dealing with this situation. Again, I ask you all to answer the question, what legitimate county purpose is served by denying this petition? I'll take any questions you have. I don't know where I'm at on time.
You're out.
Okay. So,
does anybody have any questions?
Well, the first thing I want to say is that the county has made that. I've worked in the county since 2004. I've carried haul gravel down and rocked that road. I watched the grade that road in the last 18 years. Yeah, there was a mud hole that came in there when we had a flood before the Davies come in. We hadn't got down there and repaired it. Yes, that's true. But for you to sit up and say it's not been maintained is not correct. It has been maintained. It's been maintained by the county ever since it's been down there. Now, you may have went down there and saw it at the time the mud hole was there. That you probably did. But that doesn't mean that it hasn't been maintained. And also, you know, if you take away that 300 foot that you're talking about, then that takes away all access to the property and it goes on belongs to the Davies. And, you know, that's what the people in our chapel want, is access to go to those falls. And have you really researched who owns that land? Who has the authority to make the decisions for that land?
Yes.
And you think she has the decision, his daughter?
Yes. She's his power of attorney. She stated at the highway committee meeting that both of her parents suffered from dementia, and she had her power of attorney document with her.
How come she didn't present that night to the committee?
Nobody requested it.
You didn't offer to show it either. You know, if you're going to
explain
that, then you should have showed it to the committee.
Jane, the highway superintendent and myself talked to Eldon today. Eldon said anyone that comes to this meeting on his behalf is not acting in his interest, so we don't have proof that she had power of attorney. I mean, she signed her name onto a copy of the agenda to add her name to it for her father's property, but he's definitely not foreclosing the road. The deed shows that he owns this whole section, and it's all his property that the road's on, so if it was closed, his property would be inside their gate, so Eldon Leslie's not for, you know, closing it.
Are you all suggesting that Ms. Gentry signed that in an illegal capacity or manner?
It appears to be because there was nothing offered to the committee at that time.
I can verify that.
I mean, the committee got emailed a petition by the Davies. That's what we're voting on tonight. Somebody at the meeting adding their name to it is not legal in CTAS's opinion. I mean, the committee was already voting on that, but whether or not, you know, Eldon wants to petition that, I mean, that could be another petition to the county if the Leslies and the Davies wanted to sign a petition. But Eldon told me that for over 200 years, people have been baptized at Waterloo Falls, and it's been open to the public, and he wants to keep it open on his property for the next 200 years, is what he told me. And the road superintendent numerous times, we did talk to him today, and he talked just like he did a year ago when we talked to him, that he is not for closing the road. He wants everybody to get along and wants to be peaceful with everyone, but he doesn't want to close the road.
Even if the 300 foot were taken off of the county road list, Eldon owns that 300 foot. You would still have to have his graces.
I would submit to the committee that we have it via his power of attorney.
Yeah.
Did the county attorney request an opinion from CTAS that says my road petition is illegally submitted?
No.
Okay.
I requested an opinion from CTAS that somebody could just come to any meeting we have and add their name to the petition, and they said that's not legal.
There's no restrictions on when or how they sign, and technically she doesn't even have to sign. All she had to do was voice her agreement. but I asked her to sign in an abundance of caution.
As far as building a road up out of the floodplain, there was already a road out of the floodplain before this other was taken off. There would be no reason to build another road if we left it the way it was.
Well, actually, as of today, this lower road is the only access to get into their house. The upper road that's private is washed out. So the lower road that we're talking about is passable and you can drive to their house. The upper road that the county gave back, you know, last year at the court is not passable. So this lower one's the only way they got to get to their house. So, I mean, it is passable and it has been maintained. I mean, that is your opinion too, that it's not been maintained. I have seen road graders there too. So, okay, that's, is anybody else got any questions from Andrea?
So my question is, this is not even actually the people before the court tonight's road, it's the Leslie?
They adjoined the road. Mr. Leslie owns the land the road is on. The Davies own the property around Mr. Leslie, which adjoins the road within the right way.
There are competing surveys that have been done, and there is a question about a small strip of the road right alongside the road at the Davies property line. So what my point was that the property owner, via this power of attorney that she has voiced her agreement on behalf of Mr. Leslie due to his dementia. That's why she has the power of attorney. And so any affected landowner has announced their agreement, as far as this court is concerned, that they are in agreement with the Davies petition.
So his dementia, is it in a state where he cannot make his own decision?
I don't know. I just know what Ms. Gentry represented to the Highway Committee back on April 8th. And she had her power of attorney with her there that day to show it if she needed to, but nobody asked for it. So when she signed the petition, she signed Pam Gentry, POA for Eldon Leslie.
If you have traveled through an area, even if it's personal property, for 7 years or more, we can get an attorney that will give adverse possession to the people, because there's been no reason, any trespassing signs in years. All we have to do is go get an attorney and fight, because we've been doing it for years and years, adverse possession, and they would legally allow us to go through their property where there was a road there or not.
I'm sorry, but I would respectfully disagree with that opinion.
Oh, I've seen it happen.
And, you know, you can do whatever you feel you need to do. Nothing has happened, but I would very respectfully disagree with that.
Of course, you would, you would.
Anybody else got any questions?
You know, said no other property owner would affect, all of them that's on there except you all is affected. Ms. McKinley's affected, Eldon's affected.
Adjoining property owner. And Elizabeth is not an adjoining property owner to this section of the road that we're talking about. She's on the other side, on the top side. She comes nowhere near this road, her property line is not.
So even though she was cut completely off, and the grader has to back up even to maintain it now, when it had been circling, I would call her adjoining.
She's not in a, her property line does not touch this portion of the road that's at issue.
It would just be the Davies and the Eldon. Do you have a question for her?
I said my grandparents and stuff used to run a grist mill and everything down there, and part of the old grist mill where they ground corn into the corn mill and stuff like that for people is still there. And now I'm going to be cut off from even taking grandkids or anything down there to show them, you know, where that happened. That's
you, not, you wouldn't be cut off.
No, what I got to pay to get in there.
How are we going to get
that's
down
not
there?
Correct, yes.
Court, does the Corps of Engineers own the river?
Pardon?
The Corps of Engineers. Who owns the river? Corps of Engineers?
Nobody
so,
owns the river.
That's a part of it. It's, a,
but
it's
anyway,
considered the waters of the U.S.
Yeah.
But if they are, to get there, we'd have to park way back here, walk across their property, which they probably don't want us doing anyway.
Well, they just want some cooperation from the county and the community to help them. They are increasing the value of their property, thus increasing the values of the property around them. They have created camping sites there. They have an Airbnb rental. they're gonna build small cabins there to rent. All of those things create and generate tax revenue for this county. It's a good thing, but they've gotta have some support and some help. Before they did that, you could find any drug down there you wanted. There were prostitution rings, needles everywhere. It was trashy. It was a scary place to be.
My grandfather Virgil Murphy took care of that land. My uncle Tommy took care of that land. Now, when my grandmother got very sick, the land went to a little disparate air, but their property is private property and the police couldn't back up into there. My uncle Tommy ruined I don't know how many machines trying to clean that property up. He maintained that property when it wasn't even ours for decades. So don't come in here and say that we mishandled it and there was prostitution. My mother moved back home and the police had already cleared that stuff out well before the Davies took that property over. So the stories that you're hearing were the stories prior to my brother and my sister-in-law and my mother moved back home.
I mean, I'm not trying to pull the sheriff into this, but I think the sheriff could attest.
Yes, the sheriff was involved with my mother to get stuff done.
I understand that, you know, they're good people, they've done a nice thing down there, but when you get the community involved in it and they're all upset about it, it's not a good thing. I think if the community was all in agreement with it, then we should be in agreement. But if the community's not, then I don't think we should be in agreement.
I respectfully understand the community's position, but in all respect, they do not have standing to have input in this decision.
They've lived there all their lives.
Because they're not landowners. It's like me objecting to you changing the road at your house just because I don't want to.
They've lived there all their lives and I have to have some bearing on it, I think.
Legally, it doesn't.
You've been through there 7 years, it's adverse possession. I'm telling you right now, any attorney will tell you it's adverse possession. I'll come through it all day long.
It's not.
I mean, the 300 feet is not gonna affect anything. They can still build their cabins, they can do where they want to behind their gate. But the 300, you can't use the 300 feet.
I'm making most of those on.
All right, we got a call or question.
First of all, thank you for your time.
We have got a motion that we go ahead and you make a motion to.
Vote on what's on the.
Approve the, okay, so you make a motion, Jesse Bowman made a motion.
To leave it for the county.
Well, I mean, what you're voting on is approval to deem it a private road, so somebody can make a motion and say it, but if you vote yes, is vote to make it a private road, and vote no would be leaving the county road.
I think we need to leave the county road.
I've got a motion to go ahead and vote on it, do we have a second? Billy Phipps seconded, so I've got a motion and a second to consider approval for a petition to deem a portion of the Virgil Murphy Circle a private road. And that's, the highway superintendent recommends not doing this, and so did the highway property committee.
Explain to them what they need to do if they vote against the project.
If you're voting to make it a private road, you need to vote yes. If you're voting to keep it a county road, you need to vote no. And in my opinion, as county executive, the other landowner does not want the road closed. The daughter that came, I don't know that that's a daughter, I have no proof of that, but you know, he says he don't want to close. So, clerk, you call roll. So you vote yes to make it a private road, you vote no to keep it a county road.
Billy Phipps.
No.
Jesse Bowman.
No.
Darwin Clark.
No.
Gil McCowan.
No.
Shane Walton.
No.
Frank Martin.
No.
Robbie Melton.
No.
Jeff Long.
No.
Greg Nivens. Geraldine Walker.
No.
Lee Richards.
No.
Philip Tally.
No.
Okay, petition fails and it has been left a county road. All right, number.
Does the gate come down?
There's not a gate on this portion. That's the other portion, that's a whole separate. All right. Okay, number 10, consider approval to surplus items from the following departments. There's lists attached, Register of Deeds Office, and that's been approved by the Highway and County Permanent Committee, Trustees Office, Executive Office, Veterans Office, Assessor of Property Office, and Solid Waste Department. And that's all been approved by the Budget Committee. Motion by Billy Phipps, second by Jeff Long. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Tommy Martin?
Yes.
Frank Martin?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Gil McCowen?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Jesse Baldwin?
Yes.
Philip Fields?
Yes.
Motion passes. Number 11, consider approval of trustee's letter to turn over 2019 property taxes to the property master in the amount of $65,244.62. It's been approved by the budget committee, and I talked to the property master, and she does have a length of tax sale scheduled for later this month. Got a motion by Frank Martin, second by Geraldine Walker. And that number's less than we've had in past years. Usually we've been up around $100,000 turned over, so this had more people pay the taxes this year than we have in the past. So is there any discussion, anything on that? Clerk, will you call the roll on number 11, please?
Billy Bills?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Gil McCowen?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Frank Martin?
Yes.
Bobby Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Motion passes. Number 12, consider approval to award bid for jail and senior center food and non-food for next year to Institutional Wholesale Incorporated, which is IWC. Bids were open on April 27th and approved by the budget committee. Motion by Geraldine Walker, second by Philip Tally. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Bobby Melton?
Yes.
Frank Martin?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Gil McCowen?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Philip Fields?
Yes.
Motion passes. Number 13, I'd like to go ahead and put that off to next month. That's approval of solid waste bids. We only got one bid, and the number of years is in question whether we can negotiate with them or not. So we're going to, the county attorney and myself, we're going to talk to them and see if we can negotiate the number of years to do our solid waste contract. So it don't run out till July, and that will still give us time to do that next month's court meeting. So we'll just put that off to next month's meeting. Number 14, consider approval for adding one employee to animal service. That's been approved by the salary committee. Motion Darwin Clark, second by Jeff Long. I think that's where we had a floater that was filling in, and that's making that a full-time, since we've added another ambulance and making that a full-time position. So do we have any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call the roll on 14, please?
Billy Bills?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Gil McCowen?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Frank Martin?
Yes.
Bobby Melton?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Get everybody.
Is that everybody?
She called me. Yeah.
I didn't see you.
I not called, I thought I called your name.
I might have missed.
I was waiting for somebody's one.
Darwin.
I didn't hear about it. Oh, no.
Number 15, did anybody not get called other than Darwin? All right, motion passes. Number 15, consider approval for adding Caleb Sales as death investigator for Overton County. That's recommended by Jim Morgan, who's the ambulance service director, and Dr. Presley, who's the medical director for the county and the ambulance service and the medical investigator. And that's approved by the salary committee, and that's no pay. The death investigators are not paid. Frank Martin made motion, second by Shane Walker. Is there any discussion on that? All four say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Number 16, consider approval to use hotel motel tax revenue reserves for the Chamber and Highlands annual appropriation. That's been approved by the budget committee. So in the past, when the county, when we passed our budget, we done our nonprofits, we give money to the Chamber every year for tourism. That comes out of hotel, that, you know, hotel motel money goes, supposed to go for tourism. So we've been taking that out of the general fund to give to the Chamber. But I brought it to the budget committee to let us go ahead and use the hotel motel money, because when people stay at Sandy Stone or one of the bed and breakfast, or the Airbnbs here, that money that comes in is supposed to go to tourism anyway, so it's brought up to save the money out of the, from the taxpayers on the general fund and use the hotel money, so. It'd be the same amount of money we were giving the chamber before, but now it'd come out of hotel money instead of general fund if y'all approve that.
Just cut the bill, man.
So the dollar price is right now?
It'd still be, what, they're 21?
Twenty-one.
I think 21,000 is what we put.
Yeah.
And I think it's 1,500 to the Highlands.
I make that motion.
Motion by Darwin Clark, second by Frank Martin. Any discussion? The only thing, it's gonna be the same amount of money, but like I said, it's gonna come out of the hotel money that comes in every year instead of the general fund money, so we'll help save that from the taxpayers' part. Is there any discussion on that? Clerk, will you call roll, please?
Philip Tally?
Yes.
Lee Richards?
Yes.
Randall Boswell? Geraldine Walker?
Yes.
Greg Nivens?
Yes.
Jeff Long?
Yes.
Robbie Melton?
Yes.
Frank Martin?
Yes.
Shane Walker?
Yes.
Gil McCowen?
Yes.
Darwin Clark?
Yes.
Jesse Bowman?
Yes.
Billy Bills?
Yes.
Motion passes. Number 17, consider approval for notaries at large, Lori Berta, Elliot Poston, Tanila Roska, Rachel C. Smith, Francine Presley, and if you don't have a new agenda, Tyler Chase Hunter was added late, don't you? Motion by Greg Nivens, second by Philip Tally. Is there any discussion on that? All four say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Next county commission meeting will be June 28th, 2021. That's when we will, that'll be the next meeting here, and we're gonna be meeting 2 weeks for 3 days to go over the budget at the new county building, the second floor, for the whole commission to go over that. But the next meeting will be here to pass the budget, June 28th. And also, like I say, a happy belated 29th birthday, Geraldine Walker.
Oh, thank you.
They had a birthday yesterday. I seen on Facebook, I didn't get put something on there, so happy birthday. I sung to Robbie, but I don't know that the rest of the court wants me to sing in here, so I probably won't do it. Everybody could.
I'll make a motion, you know.
Okay.
Go ahead and sing, you got the radio.
Well, go ahead. She said everybody sing. Let's go ahead. Come on, there. All righty, number 19, entertain the motions of adjournment. Motion by Billy Phipps, second by Greg Nivens. All four say aye. Those opposed, say happy birthday.
I'd like to thank the county board.